Respected dear family members, my pranams to you. You know, Indian cultural, Vedic and related literature can be classified into Puranas, which convey the great messages through stories. One, Mahabharata, which conveys the glorious messages for the life through stories and experiences of Pandavas and Kauravas. Three, Valmiki Ramayana, which conveys the messages purely through the experiences of Dasharatha's family, Bali Sugriva's family and Ravana's family. So, Purana, Mahabharata, Ramayana, Vedas. Vedas convey the messages through the pure advices and guidances. Fifth one, Upanishad, which tells you the truth and fact about our life. All these literature, learning, understanding, very difficult. But if you classify the whole parameters, factors in our life, we can classify the needed factors in our life as knowledge, jnana yoga, as action, karma yoga, as devotion, bhakti yoga. Jnana yoga, karma yoga, bhakti yoga. Jnana yoga is the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Karma yoga is the third chapter of Bhagavad Gita. And bhakti yoga is the 12th chapter. Jnana yoga, two types of jnana yogas are there. Two types of jnana. One, absolute knowledge. The other one, relative knowledge needed for our day-to-day life. Paramarthika jnanam, vyavaharika jnanam. Paramarthika jnanam is the jnanam, the knowledge which we can get about the divine power which is present within us and outside us, guiding and controlling everything. It is called prajnanam brahma, awareness and consciousness present in every living and non-living beings. Understanding that awareness and consciousness is paramarthika jnana. Vyavaharika jnana is, vyavaharika jnana, day-to-day life, this knowledge is needed. It is the jnana needed for a chartered accountant. It is the jnana needed for a doctor. Vyavaharika jnana is the jnana needed for an engineer, or a computer specialist, or an IT specialist. It is acquired knowledge. Other one, intrinsic inherent knowledge, that is knowing about the divine power, awareness and consciousness present in our body, outside the body. So paramarthika jnanam is absolute knowledge. Vyavaharika jnanam is the relative knowledge needed for our day-to-day life. This is fully explained in second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Next point. One lady happened to go. She is the chief officer connected with the health and hygiene maintenance appointed by central government, presently working in Kerala. Generally, there is a rule, a precedence, not achara, precedence, that in Sabarimala, ladies or girls between 10 to 50 should not go there. 10 to 50 should not go there. But this lady happened to go for finding out the hygienic and health aspect of Sabarimala, where crores of people are going to come during this mandala season. Some Hindus protested against it. They said that such a lady should not be taken. But remember that according to Dharma Shastra, as per Raja Kalpana, the order of the king or the order of rulers, any violation of precedence, any violation of customs and rituals are permitted. According to Dharma Shastra, according to Smriti Grandha, violation of existing rules are permitted as per the direct instruction of the rulers or the king. So merely sticking to achara, merely sticking to the precedences, merely sticking to the customs, do not mean that we are following Hindu dharma. Hindu Dharma always prompted for addition, deletion, modification and correction. There is no final word for anything. For official purpose, ladies, women entering into Sabarimala is not at all against any precedence, against any rule. So, unnecessarily creating certain type of negatives and then making them issues so that politicians will be taking maximum out of that should be avoided. Next point. You know, when Tattvamasi, that message, Rigveda has got the Mahavakya Prajnanam Brahma, Yajurveda Mahavakya Aham Brahmasmi, Samaveda Mahavakya Tattvamasi, Atharvaveda Mahavakya Ayam Atma Brahma. Prajnanam Brahma is in Aitareya Upanishad of Vedas, Rigveda. Prajnanam Brahma is in Aitareya Upanishad of Rigveda. Aham Brahmasmi is in Brahadaranya Upanishad of Yajurveda. Tattvamasi is the Mahavakya from Samaveda given in Chandokya Upanishad. Ayam Atma Brahma is the Mahavakya given in Mundaka Upanishad of Atharvaveda. So, when Tattvamasi is told, that is told as a discussion between the father and the son. Nachiketas was told to bring the fire. He brought the lamp. Then his father told, you bring the fire. He brought a lantern with the fire. Again his father told, you bring the fire. He brought a bit of burning firewood. Again the father said, you bring the fire. Then the son, Shvetaketu, told his father, without this support, how can I bring fire alone? Then the father told the son, Tattvamasi Shvetaketu. Your body is the base and Jivatma is present in that. Just like the flame is in the lamp or batti or in the thread. Thread is the support and flame is the supported one. Jivatma is present here and this body is the support. Tad tvam asi. Jivatma is the manifestation and manipulation of the divine power and the body needs that support for existing of omnipotent, omnipresent divine power, Jivatma, which is a part of Paramatma. So beautiful explanation given by somebody through WhatsApp. Next point is about Indira Gandhi. You know, Indira Gandhi was killed by her own security man. Why it happened? So the Suvarna Kshetra, golden temple of Sikh, it was just blasted in Blue Star operation or something like that by Indira Gandhi. Why that temple to which the military forces entered and fired for killing the terrorist Bindranwala? Remember that. Bindranwala was not born as a terrorist. Bindranwala was a priest in that golden temple or connected with the priesthood. And for cornering other Sikh group or for suppressing other Sikh group, the same Indira Gandhi nurtured Bindranwala. And finally he became most powerful, started spreading terrorism from the Golden Temple, and finally as Indian Prime Minister, Indira Gandhi had to send the force, military force, for evacuating the terrorists from the Golden Temple. the revengeful Sikh group killed Indira Gandhi. So who was responsible for that? You create your own enemy, finally die out of the terrorism as a victim, and finally telling that I died for India. No, you died because of your own karma balam. Rajiv Gandhi sent a military force to Ceylon, Sri Lanka, for supporting the Tamil Eelam, LTTE. There he created problem, finally ended with the LTTE itself. So remember that. Whenever the rulers do so many negatives, now in the name of minority appeasing, the politicians are also doing the same thing towards Christians and Muslims. Finally, they will become the sword for the destruction of not all the Christians, not all the Muslims, but a group. They will become the sword for the destruction of Indian culture. Through this nurturing given, a Muslim will get all the benefit. Muslim widow, Muslim teacher, Arabic teacher, Madrasa teachers, Madrasa building, the widows, everyone will be getting every type of benefit from Kerala government. None of these things will be available for, is available now for Hindu girls and boys. So much appeasement to the Muslims, to some extent to the Christians also. But Hindus are deprived of all these things. Finally, how Indira Gandhi nurtured Bindranwala, how Rajiv Gandhi nurtured LTTE, finally the negative came to them from the same hand which was nurtured. This is also happening in Kerala. Now, next point. So much discussions were going on in Malayalam about the atheist group working in Kerala. Atheist group in Kerala always try to denigrate Hindu Dharma, Indian culture. But they never touch the Christians and Muslims. So what they should have done, whether they are atheist or radicalist or something like that, instead of doing the mission-oriented work of removing the superstitions and the negatives, they have taken the mission of denigrating and degrading Hindu Dharma and our culture. Our Mahabharata, Veda, Ramayana. Finally, all these literature and all these customs and rituals and all these procedures and cultural values are remaining intact, whereas their number is decreasing. In fact, so-called progressives, so-called atheists, so-called only, not they are not really progressives or something like that. They should have done something good in removing, eradicating the superstitions. I have given so many examples, but giving the examples not needed. In some of the Kerala temples, still animal sacrifice is there. It should be removed. Still toddy, offering the toddy and liquor to the temple. That is the superstition. Bursting the crackers worth 1 crore, 1.5 crore rupees. That should be removed. And torturing the elephants in the name of temple festival. That should be removed. Great feast given to those who are rich. Giving the great feast in the name of Annadhanam in temples. That should be removed. And remember that instead of doing anything against these, whatever I said, the negatives taking place in Hindu Dharma, they are denigrating Ramayana, Mahabharata, Veda, Upanishad and so on, claiming that they are great. Maybe livelihood through taking the membership money. And I will be continuing English in the next time. Thank you very much. My pranams to you.